Hello, malt medics. Thank you to Matt Watkins for that malt medicy malt mention. And as Matt himself stated when he was mentioning his malt mention as a malt mention, he said, Ralphie, something to do with the Bristol riots. But thank goodness that is fading into the annals of history, a mere footnote to the passage of time. And before too much time passes us by, let me introduce this big badass gangster of a single malt whiskey. It's that Laphroaig again. Yes, the most, as they say themselves, and this is their claim, you know, as they say, the most richly flavoured of all Scotch whiskies. Well, if richly flavoured means a big dollop of earth, bonfire, peat, and basically something that resembles the smell and taste of one of the many layers of hell, then yes, this whiskey certainly has it. It is arguably, and certainly my opinion, one of the most strongly flavoured of Scotch whiskies. And before I, get off my gangster garb. Yeah, that's a bit more Ralphie. Before I knuckle down to tasting notes in this whiskey, what I would like to mention is that Scotch whiskey can be quite chauvinist. Unfortunately, a bit too chauvinist considering the enlightened times that we're living in. This is, after all, is it not, the information age? Yes. And part of the information in our age is that tired, cliched, old prejudices need to be tackled, need to be addressed and kicked into touch. Along with the fact that ladies like gentle, soft, sweet whiskies, like Glenfiddich and Auchentoshan. No, they don't, gentlemen. Whoever the lady is in your life, don't pour her a glass of Auchentoshan, pour her a glass of Laphroaig. She'll probably enjoy this enormously. Particularly when a woman is pregnant, her sense of smell and taste is at its most high, for the simple reason that a pregnant woman needs to protect her developing unborn child, and therefore nature decrees that the sense of smell and the sense of taste are more than men's, so as that they can identify the purity, the freshness and the lack of toxins in food and drink. There you go. Let's pour a glass and get on with this. This is the 18-year-old Laphroaig, bottled at 48%, because it needs to be. It is not chill-filtered. Good news. Bad news is, it says in the back of this label, in German, it says, mit Flabenstoff. Right. Now, you might be wondering, particularly when you're in Europe, why does Scotch whisky always mention mit Flabenstoff, which is German for with flavouring colour, flavouring stuff, colourant? Why is it in German? Well, there's a very simple reason for that, malt mates. Oh yes, it's because in Germany they have higher standards of information for customers. Yes, they do. In Britain they have lower standards because the customer doesn't matter quite as much. Mm-hmm. I know it's an opinion, but it's one that I hold near and dear. If you're in Germany, you consistently have a higher standard of welfare in what goes into drinks containers and food packaging. Yes, you do. So that the whisky industry in Scotland is perfectly able to make a declaration about colourant being in the whisky for any bottle that might be going to the German market, but if it's for other markets, they don't. Now that's a shame, really, and frankly, in my opinion, that is a bit contemptuous, disrespectful and not nice. And that, my merry maltsters, is why we should be very careful about knowing what goes into our whisky and supporting those distillers who don't put colourant in their whisky. And those who do put colourant in their whisky, yes, and don't say anything in the bottle, we should remind them that we strongly suspect that the reason that there's colourant in the whisky is because the quality of the casks used are no longer imparting the natural colour, and with it, the extra flavour. I'll leave you to think that one over. Laphroaig, 18-year-old. It's a decent one. It's got that great big seaweed briny, slightly over the top phenolic nose, but toned down quite a bit from the 10-year-old. This is the 18-year-old, so you've got more cask involvement and particularly quite a bit of sweetness coming from the casks, both sherry and bourbon. There's more fruitiness, more of a rich honey note going on here. In the nose, I'm getting smoky barbecue. You know that the American hickory, you get, if you're in America, Americans are the specialists in barbecues. These guys use big barbecues. They barbecue from scratch. They barbecue from home prepared. And generally, they do a good job of it. And the Americans, by and large, bless you, have a sweet tooth. I've been in the United States. I've seen the supermarkets full of ice cream, breakfast cereal and candy bars. I know. And on the American barbecues, apart from a can of Budweiser or Miller's or something, you will also find sweet sugar-coated sauces and pastes and brush-ons for the barbecuing meat, and this comes through in this Laphroaig cough mixture. Medicinal, oh yes, treacle, toffee, moss, that green fresh moss that you smell first thing in the morning on a stone wall, that's there. Licorice, absinthe, most certainly an absinthe note, fennel, savoury notes, bacon, coal tar, and TCP. What is TCP? It's trichlorophenol. It's a disinfectant. You can buy it in the chemists and the drugstores. And if you've got a cut and a graze, it will disinfectant for you. And that very same chemical, TCP, is actually present in very, very small quantities in heavily peated whiskey. And in my opinion, if you're drinking in moderation and not drinking to get drunk, then you have nothing to worry about from the TCP content. In fact, it'll give you a wee clean out. Taste. Oh. Big, powerful, needs water. Bear in mind, this is an older single malt. It's 18 years old. So add less water rather than more. Older whiskies take less water. So I've added 2.5 teaspoons here. Sweet. Oloroso sherry wood, sucrose, fructose, additional sweetness, ashy charcoal, and a malt that's quite savoury in style. Old wood, mint, most certainly peppermint in particular, touch of chilli, angelica, caraway, the caraway seeds, aniseed, TCP. We are now having smelt the trichlorophenol. We are now tasting trichlorophenol. If you want to know more about trichlorophenol, just wiki TCP. Crispy bacon. Yeah, there is that note in it. It makes it for the inexperienced whiskey drinker, it would actually taste a bit bizarre, but the fact that savoury note, that bacony note, is in with such other powerful flavour contributors like the aniseed, it works rather than not working. Most certainly that is the case. Savoury salt, and of course huge wafts of still relatively fresh peat smoke. There was a 21-year-old Laphroaig bottled a few years ago. It sold out, and the whisky connoisseurs around the world even now are remortgaging to try and get hold of a bottle of this. Laphroaig, when it's older, can be great. This is decent. It's not great because the sweetness seems a little too applied. The balance between the casks and the spirit isn't quite there yet. It was heading in the right direction, but it's a competent, decent quality whisky, which I would give 85 out of 100 to. Now, people might be expecting a higher mark. It is Laphroaig. It is 18 years old. It is sherry sweet influenced. It is outrageously fashionable. Sherry peaty whiskies. However, the balance and the finesse on this one isn't quite right, and I think the reason for this is it's very much being produced by volume to fulfill the growing demand out there. Now, fair enough to the producer, but it would be very interesting to put this up against a sherry cask single barrel Laphroaig from the likes of Lang's Signatory or Duncan Taylor. Now, that would be interesting. The finish thins out, seaweed, salty, and some wood smoke, but reasonably enough. So 85 out of 100, that is a malt mark. My concluding comments as regards Laphroaig 18-year-old are that it's classic sweet sherry, powerful phenolic malt delivered in a decent arrival, but a pedestrian finish. It seems stretched, as if the good casks are certainly there, you can spot them there, but as if there's some weak casks been put in just to stretch out the volume a little bit. Too much of a little bit, in my opinion. It's a promising nose, but the taste doesn't fulfil the promise of the nose. And oddly weak for a powerful tasting malt, 48%. Now, I think you've got to be so careful how much water you add to these whiskies, because they can lose their mojo if you add a bit too much water to the older whisky. So probably when you see anything 18 years and older, add half as much water as you normally would, and then leave it 5 to 10 minutes and taste it before you add any more. Okay? Thank you for watching. I think we've had enough run of single malts at the moment. I'm going to tackle another spirit shortly, and perhaps a few little location vlogs, because we haven't had them for a while. So we'll see you soon, malt mates. Hope you've enjoyed. I have. I continue to do so. Buying these whiskies, opening them up, writing down my tasting notes and telling you all about it. And hopefully, fingers crossed, when you go out and spend your hard-earned cash in whiskey, I'm a little bit of an influence to make sure that your cash is well spent rather than misspent. Thanks for watching. See you again shortly.